Well, football season is back, but the game that captivates the country also comes with serious concussion concerns. Now, the Wisconsin Badgers are teaming up with the NFL to learn about what kinds of hits results in head injuries. New at 6, Ben Jordan goes in depth on how the partnership hopes to make the game safer to play.
UW-Madison is one of 8 universities where football players are using these mouthguards this season to not only protect their teeth, but also their heads. The partnership with the NFL is on a mission to cut down on high-impact head injuries.
All UW-Madison football players wear mouthguards.
The mouthguard material is the same as a standard mouthguard.
But unlike regular mouthguards, certain Badgers players are wearing ones that have special sensors inside. UW-Madison professor and researcher Dan Kobian is in charge of analyzing the data that's collected. He says there have been all sorts of studies where sensors have been placed on football players' helmets. But since helmets vibrate and often move independently from the skull, Dan says custom mouthguards can provide more precise information on hits because they always fit tight and stay in place.
A lot of potential goals to this study, the most basic, just in one sentence, right, is to quantify the head impacts sustained by University of Wisconsin football players on the practice field and during competition.
Dan says the NFL picked UW-Madison as one of its participating schools for 2 reasons. First, the caliber of players on the Badgers football team, followed by its research institutions on the academic side to evaluate the data.
What's the most interesting thing you've learned so far?
The most interesting thing I would say is the variation across players. So we can have players that play the same position that have not just very different maybe total numbers or intensity of impact, but the direction of impact.
Dan says this is an image of a culmination of hits a player took over the course of a season. The bright red section indicates the worst impact behind the forehead.
Do you think the game of football is much safer today than it was 20 years ago?
That's a really, really hard question to answer. Certainly, protective equipment is much better. We're much more aware of these things. Maybe the diagnosis, maybe even the treatment for things has improved. At the same time, we can also say that the players are bigger and stronger. They move faster. The magnitude of impact, the intensity of the impacts are greater.
Dan says he isn't allowed to share how many concussions the UW-Madison football team has recorded, but a former Badger, Tony Magna, knows from firsthand experience it happens all the time.
How many concussions would you say you had while you played college football?
I would say dozens. The players up at Wisconsin, they're just enormous, and I was undersized, so you had to play violent in order to be successful in the game.
The former Oak Creek High School standout turned varsity letter winner at UW-Madison gave up the game his junior year because the pain from concussions became too much to bear.
It was daily headaches, spiking headaches, and then when I would start practice, I would get vertigo. So the room spinning, nausea.
Tony says he still has constant, albeit mild, headaches a decade later.
Are you concerned that you may one day be diagnosed with CTE?
Absolutely, yeah. And so it's become my life's work to make sure that that doesn't happen.
Now, Tony provides treatment to other athletes of high-impact sports.
One here?
Yeah,
you like that one.
When it comes to UW-Madison's partnership with the NFL to study concussions, Tony believes more of a focus needs to be on therapy and treatment strategies rather than gathering data on the hits themselves.
Otherwise, you're just leaving these guys behind. You graduate and they just send guys on their way.
UW-Madison says their data collection efforts could ultimately help the NFL make decisions from equipment changes to proper training, such as technique on how players tackle each other and potentially eliminating practice drills that often lead to concussions as well. Reporting at UW-Madison, Ben Jordan, TMJ4 News.
And last November, 20 Badgers players voluntarily participated in the pilot study through the end of last season. This year, the study has twice as many players. Every hit they take in practice and during games are analyzed each day. Now, this year, for the first time, some NFL players were required to wear the Guardian caps, or those padded helmets. You've seen them, right? During practice, the NFL says the Guardian cap did help reduce the number of concussions by more than 50%. A decision has not been made yet about if these helmets will be required in the future, though some players have chosen to keep wearing them on their own.